Reavers, of course.
Watch out! It's a Soul Eater! It doesn't belong here! We must get rid of it!
Mind you, watch out!
Protect yourself! The Alpha!
Hopefully the objects I'm looking for are still here.
Learn anything?
Door is shut. If memory serves, we'll need to light both of those torches to open it. This is a mystic fire. Its flames are short-lived. So much about that day I wish I could change. If only I'd seen the signs.
Join him.
Yeah.
crest of the Hewley family. One of the first families ripped apart by the war. My circlet's here.
It's on that pedestal by the balcony!
We must remove these creatures first!
A symbol of commitment. After the ceremony, he had a new one made every week, each more beautiful than the last. He stopped when I refused to teach him the old magic. You know, my people used to send me gifts too, so I wouldn't forget home. But after the birth of my son, they stopped too. I can't read that from here. Let's head back and I can take a better look. I thought I'd feel peace by breaking it. But I feel nothing.
Perhaps what you seek cannot be found in a circlet.
You may be right.
Come on, Kratos! Off your back!
That's it.
From the ceremony.
A symbol of reconciliation. We drank from the lover's chalice until we could hardly stand. I confided in him that night about wanting an apology from Freyr. Odin reassured me that he'd be the only family I'd need. And I believed him.
What's it say, brother?
Ah! It's a denouncement from my people, placed during my wedding. The word is complete, but I still can't read it from here. Let's head back down.
Better now?
No. The pain only grows. Will I never be free of it? What more do I need to do? Side of this door scare me most.
The most difficult battles are fought within, but this battle, you will not fight alone. Are you ready?
Yes. There it is. My final tie to Asgard. We drove that sword into the pillar together. The sword was forged for the ceremony. A symbol of our union.
The stone refuses to let go.
The deepest wounds form the strongest bonds. Bastard said it as part of our vows. I hate it when he's right. Asgard holds a part of me I can't sever. My bond to my son. To the Valkyries. That damn realm isn't just Odin's. It belongs to me, too. The pain he caused is his. I refuse to keep holding on to it.
The sword no longer holds our legacy. But it will serve as mine.
A much more fitting use for it.
Anything interesting, brother?
I suppose it's on to the next battle now.
Yes. You won an important one today.
Just
I owe
you my life, such as it is, and I caused you so much pain, but you're in a terrible situation. For that, Freya, I am truly sorry.
I wanted to end that war too.
I know, but I swear to do better by you nonetheless. Anything you ask, consider it done. I'm forever in your debt.
I appreciate that. Even if you can't help being an obnoxious know-it-all.
I'm afraid I'll never know how to stop doing that, Your Majesty.
You know, an arrogant man once told me you can't change the past, only how it shapes you. I think he might be right. It's been a while since I've had a confidant. Would the god of few words lend me his ear now and again?
As long as I am needed. Said. The ace here burned him.
Yes. We weren't yet at war, but relations with the Vanir and Aesir had been hostile for ages. Freyr got it into his head that he could improve relations by sharing our magic with them. Vanir techniques for bountiful harvests, enough to feed their whole population. Getting set on fire was the thanks he got.
That's true. The Aesir were too undisciplined and impatient for the subtlety of Vanir spellcraft. So when things went wrong, they blamed their teacher.
So Freyr was a guest when Odin burned him?
Not exactly. Odin didn't mind locking Freyr up. He saw the potential of the magic and wanted to know more than how to improve crop yields. And we'll just stop there for now.
Oh, I know that face. You got something for me, don't you?
Here.
Oh, well, thank you so much. Elsa's been itching to get her ball back all dang winter. It's her favorite toy.
What?
Now, if you could find the rest of my armor set I left out there, I'll repair it for you. Free of charge, even. Oh, actually, any dwarf can. I just didn't think you'd get my orb for me if you knew that. Sorry, y'all.
Good thing you were so cautious, brother.
Quiet.
He's right, Mimir. Show respect. The squeaky toy could have been the death of us all.
And it nearly was.
Do not laugh.
It's hard not to, brother.
Try.
Okay. Okay.
Mess some folks up. And now for the goddess. Let's make something then. Keep your bits in all the right places.
A good fit.
Damn! Am I good or what? You won't get so much as a paper cut in that. Feels like there was something else.
And how is it you two know each other?
Nah, I can't be divulger in guild business. You gotta respect the secret.
I'm sorry?
Let's just say Brock and I have long enjoyed certain... interests.
That's right. Like you find there.
This crest. It's mine. Are we off to find that elven sanctum then, or something else?
We certainly can. Though we do have something else that needs our attention. We found a Hofgufer out in the Barrens, my lady. In terrible pain. We freed it, but there's another in turn somewhere beneath the Forbidden Sands.
A Hofgufer? I haven't seen one since I was a child.
And what else? There's still that secret elven library in Alfheim.
Lead the way.
That armor looks like Lunda's design. I can fix it up for you if you like.
Come here. What did you mean when you said Frey was... not exactly a guest of the Aesir.
I meant, by the time they burned it, he'd been a prisoner for some time. It was a mob of lesser Aesir, bitter and short-sighted, who tied him up and lit him aflame as punishment for the sabotage they imagined him guilty of. Obviously, he survived. In fact, he used the opportunity to escape. But such an affront made war inevitable.
Set that aside for now. Come.
Much of the sand has been cleared away, but another storm rages beyond that pass, which must mean...
another Hofgufer!
Odd. It looks as though the Light Elves sealed off this section of the Barrens. Why?
Luckily for us, a very considerate goddess has enhanced our magic chisel, and we can unseal it.
My. That is lucky.
The Forbidden Sands lay beyond.
Contested territory, according to Bela. And another storm to endure.
I remember when Freyr and I traveled to this realm as children. The desert was healthy and full of life back then. I can't help but fear that era has ended for good and our efforts here are futile.
It's a fair concern. Healing this land will take more than a pair of singing Hofgufer. But I have to believe, in the long run, we're doing right by Alfheim. Well, best we start looking for a way underground.
Keep a lookout for a cave! The other Hofgufer! Tifa must be under there! An entrance!
I hope Freyr will appreciate our work here in the desert. I wonder if he knows how poorly this realm has fared in his absence.
Aye. Hearing the Song of the Sands again is a rare privilege, even if it's only a solo act.
Or a duet. Once this Hofgufa is free. This architecture... it is not of the Dark Elves.
An abandoned ancient settlement, by the looks of it. Built long before the Lightwell's creation.
More hive better as well.
I'd say we're on the right track, then.
Hive material is sensitive to sound. How odd. When I last came here with you and Atreus, I assumed the absence of Alfheim's light was an aberration. I didn't realize it was covered by this matter.
Aye. And as far as the Dark Elves are concerned, it's that light column in the center of the temple that's the aberration. Just look at how old some of these surfaces are. Far older than the Lightwell, or even our trapped Hofgufa for that matter.
That's quite the empathetic perspective, Mimir.
Well, dangle from a burly god's backside for a few winters, and you'll find yourself looking for all sorts of new perspectives.
Stone on the ground will help. Well, there you go.
Enemy behind you! Switching!
Watch your left!
Don't often travel underneath the barons, do they?
Territory changes hands often in Alfheim. Also, it appears.
Bigvir did mention that these ruins have historical significance for the Light Elves. I assume they're only here to keep intruders out.
Well, at least they tried.
I suspect the corpse below would disagree.
There. That hive doesn't like sound, remember?
Good eye. Let's continue, shall we?
Good hit, brother!
I hope freeing these half-goofers will allow them to breed again. It was a dazzling display once. The skies of Alfheim filled with their song.
I imagine it's the lack of fresh light that's caused this pair to grow abnormally large. No use in having babies if there's nothing for them to feed on.
Trying to protect their children from a harsh world. I can relate. I wonder if these two comprehend the choice they face once free.
What choice do you speak of?
The life cycle of the Hofgufa. In order to breed, they must pass on their life to their children.
And without life, they will die.
I suppose that's all any of us can hope for in the end. That our death has purpose. That we can live on through our children. Given another chance. almost there.
Back to the surface, then.
Used in many of Freyr's blessings, I imagine.
The fate of these creatures, it reminds me of a story.
Does it?
There once was a blacksmith whose king commanded him to construct a box that could contain all the evils of the world. But no metal could hold such a power. So the blacksmith used the flame
Kratos,
of...
Kratos, is this a story meant to ease my grief?
Perhaps it is just a story. A way to pass the time.
I appreciate the sentiment, but... No, your stories...
What about my stories?
I wouldn't exactly call them a comfort.
Fair. Mimir is a better storyteller.
Now don't sell yourself short, brother. You've come a long way from the days of laconic fables.
It's okay. Finish your story, Kratos.
The blacksmith's daughter was the key to unlocking the box. He died trying to protect her from those who would open it.
At least it's a relatable story.
appears we've overstayed our welcome in Alfheim.
Time to end this storm.
Stories are of no comfort. Take solace in knowing you did what you thought was best for your son's safety. Even these creatures know. There is little choice for a parent. You are not alone.
I'm not, am I? And now neither are they. Thank you, Kratos. This land sings once more. We've done good here.
No rush to leave yet, is there? Who knows what kind of adventures await us in a freshly lit barrens?
To tell of Freya being burned by the Aesir mob.
Well,
no more.
Hold that thought. I think it's about to get vile.
Ryor, throw your weapon at it!
Token.
A badge of honor. The elves made a few of these. They'd hang them up outside their dwellings, show their support for my brother.
The Alpha!
Two keys.
What are they keeping back there?
That's the beauty of a locked door. It could be anything. Monsters, treasure. Knowing our luck, it'll be a bit of both.
A light elf statue in the desert. Odd.
Aye. Yeah, Brett, this is the sanctum.
What is that?
A phantom! Rogue magic! Came for the runic core!
Bloody hell! Look at that thing!
The Alpha!
Attack!
The core is weakened!
Need to take out those swings, brother!
Go!
Go!
How it felt to lose your head.
What would you have me say? That it tickled?
Merely.
if you wish to derive some satisfaction from my pain, I'm afraid you'll be disappointed. Kratos swung swift and true, didn't you, brother? I felt nary a scratch.
Shame.
Another sleeping troll, courtesy of the dwarves.
Freya. Here.
A dawn bloom. You have an interest in botanicals now? I would have beaten you.
What?
Earlier. If Atreus hadn't been there.
Perhaps.
We could go again. Find out for certain.
I would rather not.
I'll bet you wouldn't.
To tell of Freya being burned by the Aesir mob.
Well, Freyr certainly wasn't the same after that. At least for a while. His carefree ways were replaced with nightmares, paranoia, and lashing out. It doesn't excuse what he said at my wedding, but I do understand where he's coming from. The magic draining out of all of us has to end up somewhere.
Yeah.
Sigil arrows won't work on this.